I'm Jake Adams. I am visiting the Worldwide Corals retail store here for Reefpalooza Orlando. And just about to head out the doors to go to the satellite farm, because Worldwide Corals is all about coral culture. But I stumbled upon a great Pico reef tank, a tiny little 3 or 4 gallon aquarium. And I got my buddy Bobby holding the camera. And we're just going to do a quick and dirty on this tank. So Bobby. So this is Bobby, and you guys have a ton of displays here, and everyone kind of owns, you know, tanks of their own, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so this is your Pico Reef.
This is my Pico Reef.
All right, just give us a brief rundown, top to bottom, volume, age, dimensions, light, etc.
It's a Marineland 2.5 gallon Pico. We have a Kessel A80 on it. I upgraded the pump to a cobalt return pump. So that's all the water flow it really has.
So you only have the return pump for water flow?
Yes.
Right on. You got a Kessel A80.
Mm-hmm.
And I switched it to white so it looks okay for the camera, but you run it blue most of the time?
In the morning when I first get here, I have it on white for most of the day. Right when we open, I come up and turn it on blue.
Very cool. So how long has this tank been set up?
It's been set up about 8 months.
8 months, and yeah. You said it's 2.5 gallons?
2.5 gallons.
Wow. Yeah. Now for maintenance on this thing, you don't dose, do you?
No, I don't dose at all, but I started out, and it sounds kind of extreme, but I started out doing 300% water changes a week. Now it's fairly established and I'm down to 2, which I mean, it's like half a bucket.
Did you go through like a basic algae cycle, algae blooms and stuff?
Oh yeah. That's why I was doing the 300% water changes a week. And it used to be in the back on my desk on the frag station.
Right.
But as it's filled in, we brought it out to the front.
So no dosing, no testing, no chemical filtration, no protein skimmer.
Nope.
Just, you know, periodic 100% water changes.
Yep.
And what salt do you use for the water change?
We use the Neomarine Brightwell salt.
Very cool. Now, if somebody wanted to get into a reef tank like this, what's your advice for a Pico tank?
It helps to have water ready. So, you know, just have a store where you can get water or mix up your own water. Go kind of slow with it at first until you get the hang of it, and don't be afraid of water changes. They're not that bad, especially in these small tanks.
Right. So another thing that people always ask me is like, what ATO do I use for small tanks? And I just cover the tank so it doesn't evaporate.
Covered.
Is that what you're doing too?
Absolutely. It's got this glass top. I always make sure this black part is covering so we get minimal water evaporation. And then doing those 100% water changes multiple times a week helps.
And then so having a top on there and it completely sealed keeps it warm. Do you have to have a heater for it?
We do have a heater because we do have the AC crank because the AC actually keeps all of our other tanks in the facility temperature stable.
Right on.
So with this one, it's so small, we do at 74 with the AC set, we really need a heater on this one.
All right, very good. And then what are the corals that you recommend for a Pico reef tank like this?
Oh gosh, zoas. These euphilias have been doing great. The candy cane's amazing. We just recently put those gonies in there and they're doing fantastic.
And then a couple curious things that you have in here is that's a yellow filter feeding sea cucumber in the back?
Yeah. I mean, it seems to be doing really well. It was really small when we got it in, and I thought, well, you know, small thing, small tank. It should work out pretty well.
And then another cool thing that you have, which is kind of, let's see if I can get a clip of it. You got a little tiny anglerfish, right?
Yeah.
Right on. How often do you feed that guy?
The feeding is done by the guys in the front here. I usually just do the maintenance. I would suspect that we feed them at least once or twice a week.
Oh, very good. Yeah, so the only thing I would add is that Pico reef tanks are like an amazing set up for ornamental shrimp.
Oh, you know, absolutely.
Shrimp are just as cool as fish and cooler in some ways. So this is the kind of tanks I like to see, like coral shrimp, anemone shrimp.
Yeah.
Any of the various like exotic coral banded shrimp.
Yeah.
And even just a cleaner shrimp, man. So very cool, man. Good job on this tank.
Thank you.
You know, I love tanks of all sizes and shapes, but I really like an outstanding Pico Reef. So good job, buddy.
Thank you.
Thanks for your time, and we're going to go ahead to the farm.
Let's go ahead to the farm. We'll be right back.